We're on the road. We're on the road now to an exciting adventure. Da, 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 da.
Why not right up close? We are in Lemington's bar. We was looking for coffee, but we ended up with expensive ice cream instead. And it's a really, 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 really kind of weird place. Apparently they've got elephants that have a bath here, and they've also got Queen Victoria, who got her bum blown off.
Queen Victoria? Queen Victoria got blown off her arse?
Yeah, she's got a fat arse as well.
Never moved it.
And down there is a man talking about truth seeking, so they're quite awake here.
Well, here we are in Royal Lemington Spa on the way to a couple of days in Stratford-on-Avon. It's 26 degrees today, and a lovely day, and we've been having a £10 ice cream.
It's really nice though.
Yeah.
A nice ice cream.
Very nice ice cream. We're walking down towards the park. This is where the coach will be a little bit later to take us. There's a statue of Queen Victoria here on a huge marble plinth. And apparently the base of the marble plinth is 1.5 inches off centre. And why is it 1.5 inches off centre?
Because Queen Victoria is really fat. Tipped over.
Not really. According to the bus driver, there was a bomb fell here in the Second World War, and the force of the explosion forced the plinth over. Knocked Queen Victoria's arse to one side.
Yes.
And I don't know if we can see it here, but you probably can. Oh. Yes, it actually says it on there.
It was on the 14th of November 1940.
And it's this bit of plinth here that's been moved.
I'm not going to stand under it.
This is the park in Royal Lemington Spa. And apparently, I think this is the elephant bath. No idea why you would have an elephant bath, but... Oh, maybe it's not. It's a lovely little park. This place is called the Glass House. And it looks very much like there's a tropical garden inside, so we'll go and have a look. And you're not allowed in if you've got COVID symptoms.
Oh, that's nice.
It's just unbelievably hot here today. That looks good, that, getting into the water. This is where we're staying, the Royal Court Hotel, just outside of Coventry.
We thought we might escape, but we've just broken free of the perimeters, past the searchlights and the guard dogs, and we've come to the main road, but there's not really anywhere to escape to. There is a bus stop, and a sports ground.
This is the largest hotel in Coventry, and it's a country manor that was owned by somebody called Hillman.
He made Hillman in cars. Yeah, a Hillman guy.
And it's the largest hotel in Coventry, but this is where it is. Kind of miles from anywhere. There is no escape. We've just been dropped off here. It's Morton in the Marsh. Wow. And it's market day. And we've just been dropped off and having a look around. And there we go, look.
That's a bank.
It's Morton in the Marsh, I'm saying.
Yeah, I know, but photographs. Not just the bank.
So we'll get a bit more of the market when we come up the other side.
This is called Toy Cottage. This is really exciting. It's got a dog on wheels. It's Dougal. And look, it's got one of them little monkeys that goes has symbols. And oh, that's cute. Oh.
And it's called Toy Cottage, and we're just coming up to the market in Morton on the Marsh.
Oh,
the bell in. I can remember going into that a few times when I was down here at the college. Burton on the water, and here it is. Wow, our first view. Full of people just like us, pensioners with walking sticks, but nevertheless it's a really nice place on probably one of the best days of the summer, 26, 27 degrees. This is the water that it's on. That Burton on the water is on this water. The last time we were here, there was hardly anybody here. It's absolutely packed today. Wow. Yeah. Even I have to admit it's a beautiful place, even though it's packed. It's a real picturesque place. And that is a Ferrari that's just gone past.
There's a motor museum over there, look. It's
just unbelievable the amount of people that's here. There's a Ferrari coming again. Little doggies.
This is our feet in the Wold River. There's Peter. And he screamed like a baby.
It's quite cold.
It's not cold at all. Not for somebody who goes in the sea and has cold showers. Everybody's got their feet in the water. So pretty. I found a willow tree to make new toothbrushes.
It's boiling,
Peter.
My feet have gone numb.
Well, that's because you need to get in the sea every day and get used to it.
Come back. Don't jump. She's in the middle of the water. This is our hotel. Huge place. Part of it is an old building there, beautiful old building with a massive annex on. Apparently it's the largest hotel in the area. And here's Adriana. Tell us about it.
Okay, well today we're going to Stratford-upon-Avon, but we've chosen not to do any tours because it sounds as though it could be pretty stressful and you have to book them way in advance. So we're just going to go there, we're just going to chill and hopefully just do our own thing, and hopefully we might get more than 2 hours, because so far we've been to, Lytham St Anne's, which is like this big white place. Where
Lytham St Anne's? We've been to Morton on the Marsh.
No, we went to Lytham.
And Burton on the Water.
Lytham the first day. On the way, the one with the white buildings.
All right, okay.
Yeah. And it was, they had a beautiful park there, which was really, really nice. But yesterday we went to Morton on the Marsh, which was Peter's fireplace. But you get off the bus, right, and you've got like 2 hours and that's it, right? And by the time you find a cup of coffee and where the toilets are and everything else, it's like back on the bus again, right? And then we went to Burton on the Water. Now Burton on the Water is nice because you could have a paddle in the stream, but you only get like 2.5 hours. And then you come back and it's like you're just kind of sitting around here, you know, and there's no escape because there's nowhere to go.
It's a nice place though. But there's nowhere to go.
That building's nice, but the rooms are just kind of soulless. But the food's good.
And so anyway, we're going to a William Shakespeare place today, aren't we?
To be or not to
be? Yes, but
we aren't
going to do the William bit. And there's a bus down there just getting ready. This is Stratford-on-Avon, and would you believe it, we're down by the River Avon, and there's lots of little boaty things. And we're getting on one of them.
They're called barges, Peter.
And we're going to be taking on a little guided tour, and we'll go through a lock, and here's a lock here. It's got a couple of gates on it. And we're going to get on one of these things and be told all stuff about the guy over there on the statue, about William. I think there's 2 versions of the story, but we'll probably only get one here while we're here.
Been turned into an ice cream. To be or not to be? This is the question.
And that is the one we're going on, this one called Jennifer May.
Or she may not.
Or she may not.
Female architect in the country to design such a highly described it as unspeakably ugly.
Okay, babies.
In general, there, the design proved popular and held its way into the This is the rather industrial looking daisy chain belt, linked together to ensure that no bird can accidentally hit the bike or the skirt. Beyond the boom, you might be able to make out the large metal sluices, which are used to control the river levels and prevent Stratford from flooding. The turn can take some effort. The boat is nearly 70 feet long, flat-bottomed and very heavy. Just about be able to make out the modern post-industrial lines of the other place. Briefly renamed the Cotswold Theatre a few years back, it has now reverted to its original moniker. Although some people deliberately refer to it as the Rusty Shed. The theatre is primarily used by the Royal Shakespeare Company to show.
Hello.
But the realization that many diseases such as colic or typhus or water
naturally. They like that look, don't they? Keep them going for the brand.
This is a form of trap. Although the remains of the horseboard and tram cars are still visible, especially at night when they are illuminated. The second and larger bridge is the road crossing, or cottage bridge, named after another notable less well-known. Whether that is in the north of the turnpike, it is a secure new one. By firmly securing the work, the crew ensure minimal movement and pleasant luck. The genital name is the wise man of the world. Why does he know about the design sphere and some of his most famous characters? Hamlet, Lady Macbeth, Falstaff, and Henry V. Shortly, we will make a 180-degree turn to get back to the mooring. This is no mean feat, and you may notice a crew member at the front measuring the distance to the wall. Since the boat is nearly as long as the basin is wide, it calls for precision helmsmanship from the skipper. If there's any significant wind, you may hear the bow thrusters being engaged to help with the turn. The water here is only around 4 feet deep, so it helps if the boat doesn't have a keel. On the windows, you may see the clouds of mud and soot snarled out by the boat's propellers and turbines on a shallow hill. In the far corner of the basin, there is a small tower that is the unassuming object of two hours. Now that is
real old building here, part of the Shakespeare story, I suppose. Wow, really old gates. Bit more of the main street in Stratford here, a lot of Tudor-y kind of buildings. How many of them are genuine, I've no idea. But certainly a few of them look quite old. Years old, those ones. It actually says on the front 1564.
Yeah.
That one. Lots of very quaint buildings here in Stratford, and monuments, an old kind of Tudor type architecture. Loads of them actually. It's quite a nice little place.
It looks like a slice of cake.
And up there is the, on the left, the white building behind the transit vans called the Playhouse. Yes,
we've
it's
got to go and see Shakespeare before we go.
26 degrees or something today, it's roasting.
These are the canal boats. So if you've got a boat, which would be really, really cool, you can come and berth here for 2 days, I think. And there's the big wheel up there, which we would probably go in, but Peter would be scared, so we can't. It's really, really hot. It's like 30 degrees or something. But before we go back to the bus, we've got to go and see William. And there he is on his chair. Look, he gets to have his chair on his plinth up the top. And supposedly, these statues are all his characters. So, okay, so who do we have here? Oh, alas, poor Yorick. Alas, poor Warwick. His head fell off.
Is that alas, poor Warwick?
Well, I think so, because his head fell off. So he's going, oh dear, alas, poor Warwick. It's Hamlet. Okay, is this King Lear just about to put his crown
on? This one looks gay.
You might have been, but so what? This one is Prince Hal. Hello, Prince Hal. There is. Will you just be sensible? We are in the presence of the bard. And this kind of surrounded by these weird things. Phew. Okay, so who's this? This one is this Faustus? Let's have a look. Who's this? Falstaff. It's Falstaff.
Probably,
oh, my bag's falling to bits.
Probably a loaf of pie maker.
Well, he's certainly eating a lot of pies. Look at the belly on him.
Yeah.
Okay, and then we've got one more to go and visit. Who's she? She is... Oh, she looks quite poor. She hasn't... Oh, it's out of Macbeth. Oh, Lady Macbeth. It's Lady Macbeth. And it's beautiful here because there's like somebody singing and it's just really pretty. This is the lock that we were in earlier. The lock that we went down in. It was really good fun coming up because you feel it more when you come up in the boat than when you come down. See? The Stratford upon Avon Canal.
Here we are in a place called Litchfield on our way home. It's got a few churches in apparently. And that's one of them up there. So we're going to have a little bit walk around. I don't really know what's here, apart from closed shops. Look at the size of that. It's spooky.
Looks a nice guy.
There was apparently some massive battles here during the English Civil War in 1650 or something. But that's a real spooky looking cathedral or whatever it is. It's absolutely huge. Who's that?
St. Chad. Yeah.
Looks like he's sticking his fingers up at somebody.
He's the patron saint of people who live on council estates.
My goodness me. Look at that. Yep, and then further down, that's all part of it as well, the next spire.
I think what happened was they built the first spire and then the architect was inspired to build more.
To build the other two. Wow.
Huge. But it sounds amazing when we've got the organ going. Wow, look at all the carving on the altar. The windows set quite a way back from the altar. This is the altar at Litchfield. Pretty amazing. Look at those windows on the plane, the ceiling. Lovely little paintings around there, look. The windows are like, whoa. Pretty impressive, what?
It's spooky. Another part of Lichfield, this is just in the centre. We're just having a little bit of look, a nice little town. Right in the background there is the cathedral we're at, and this one is a nearer one, which is probably for the poorer people because it's smaller.